Hello everyone, good morning and welcome to the Morning Tales for June 20, 2019. And I hope you are watching the Morning Tales for all these days. These are very important current affairs. And people are asking about the PDFs for the Morning Tales. So you know that we are already updating the current affairs on our website. You can find the daily current affairs on the website. Also, you can find the monthly current affairs as well. So you can find the link on the website www.anujjindal.in, or you can just go to the description box and there you can directly go to the website and download the current affairs. So all these important current affairs are already covered in that. So don't worry and just download the PDF from the website. Now, starting with the first question. So Operation Sunrise is coordinated operation across the borders to bust terror groups between India and So when we are talking about this Operation Sunrise, so there are various operations being conducted and the armies usually give the name to these operations. So it becomes important that you remember about the operations and their name which is associated with it, or the purpose for which that operation has been created. So the Operation Sunrise is associated with between the, or it is associated with India and Myanmar. Now what has happened is, this is the second phase of this Operation Sunrise 2, and the first phase was conducted approximately 3 months ago, and that too during the across the Indo-Myanmar border. Now the operation armies of India and Myanmar, they are carrying these 3 week long operations, and that too along the borders of India and Myanmar. So basically they want to bust the terror groups which are operating in Manipur, Nagaland and Assam. So we know about the situation of the Maoists and the terrorist group which are there in the northeast. So therefore Operation Sunrise is associated with India and Myanmar. Moving on to the next question, and quite important question. So who has been elected as the speaker of the 17th Lok Sabha? Now this has been done after the successive 8 years of tenure which was completed by Sumitra Mahajan. So we know about Sumitra Mahajan, she was the Lok Sabha speaker for these 8 years. Now she has been replaced and the 17th Lok Sabha speaker has been announced. Who has been appointed? So Om Birla has been appointed as the 17th Lok Sabha speaker. So what probable questions can come? Only two probable questions can come out of this. The first one, that who is the current Lok Sabha speaker, the 17th Lok Sabha speaker, Om Birla, and whom he has replaced. So he has replaced Sumitra Mahajan, who was on this position for 8 years. The next question for today is, who among the following has won the Eco Champions of Recycling Award 2019 by UAE? As just an 8-year-old Nia Toni. So she is 8-year-old girl and she has been awarded with this Eco Champions of Recycling Award 2019. Now what you need to know about these awards, that what is the purpose of this award and why she has been awarded. So she basically won this award in the paper section. So paper section in the individual category, that was the category in which she won the awards, where she collected approximately 14,914 kg of the paper waste. So this Eco Champions of Recycling Award is associated with the recycling and the environment. So it becomes important to note the purpose of these awards. So this girl collected this paper so that these can be recycled, and therefore she has been awarded for the same. Now this is a part of the campaign which was organized by the Emirates Environmental Group, the EEG, which is a NGO or an organization which is non-governmental and professional working group which is based out of UAE. So that was the purpose, so to recycle the waste. So this is the purpose of this organization to start this campaign, and for the same campaign Nia Toni has been awarded. The next question, and static question, so there is a reason behind this question. So where is the Chokhandi Stupa located? So this Chokhandi Stupa has been declared as the area or the monument of national importance, and that has been declared by the Archaeological Survey of India. So this Archaeological Survey of India declared this Chokhandi Stupa, which is located in Sarnath, UP. So Sarnath, UP, it is located in Sarnath, UP, and it has been declared as the monument of national importance. Now, therefore, this is the reason behind including this Chaukandi Stupa question over here. So a question can come, where is this Chaukandi Stupa located? Now, the question for you here is that which ministry is actually involved in all these notification. So there was one notification issued by some ministry for which you need to answer in the comment section that which ministry has declared or under which ministry the Archaeological Survey of India has declared Chaukandi Stupa, which is located in Sarnath, UP, as the Monument of National Importance. Remember this thing that the ministries associated with these notifications are very important, or not exactly monument, but it has been declared as the protected area as of now. So we cannot say it as a monument, but the protected area of national importance has been declared. This stupa has been declared as the protected area of national importance. So do tell me in the comment section. And now moving to the next question. So which company is the most attractive employer brand of India according to the Randstad employer brand research? So there was this findings by the Randstad employer brand research, which found out that the e-commerce giant. So who among the following is the e-commerce giant in these options? So Amazon is the answer for this question. So according to this research, it was found out that Amazon has been declared, or it is the most attractive employer brand of India according to this Randstad employer brand research. Now the follow-up or the second position was taken over by Microsoft India, and the third position was taken over by Sony India. So it was found out that only 9% of the people prefer to work in the startups, and mostly people prefer to work in MNCs. So you must know about the answer that Amazon has been declared as the most attractive employer brand. Now next question is very, very important from the exam point of view. So according to the United Nations World Population Prospects 2019, now recently this United Nations report has been declared, where it was found out that the global population is expected to grow by dash by 2050. So currently we know that there are approximately 7.7 billion people, or the world population is 7.7 billion as of now, which is expected to grow to 9.7 billion in 2050, by 2050. So the answer of this question is 9.7 billion. Now apart from these statistics or these figures, you must know about the India's current population and what would be the India's impact, or what would be the impact of the population on India by 2050. So if we look in the duration between 2019 to 2050, so India is expected to add nearly 273 million people in this duration. 273 million people, it's a very huge number. And you need to tell me in the comment section. So now it's a very interesting thing if you know about the current population of India. So tell me in the comment section that what is the current population of India. As soon we are going to replace China and we'll become the world's most populous country in the world. So currently China is the world's most populous country with 1.43 billion people, and as of now we are at the second position. So you need to tell me in the comment section what is the current population of India. The next is, who has been awarded with the 2019 Amnesty Human Rights Award? So the 2019, first of all, this Amnesty Human Rights Award honors the people and the groups. So not only people, but the groups are being honored under this Amnesty Human Rights Award, where they advance the, or where they work for the cause of the human rights. Now for 2019, Greta Thunberg has been awarded with this 2019 Amnesty Human Rights Award. And along with this, she was awarded for her global movement, which is known as Fridays for Future. So this Fridays for Future was the global campaign of Greta Thunberg, under which she inspired the school students to skip the schools on Friday and attend the demonstrations calling for the climate change in the world. So this Fridays for Future was the climate change action movement. So it was working towards the it was an action towards the climate change, and this was the initiative taken by the Greta Thunberg, and she has been awarded with this 2019 Amnesty Human Rights Award. It's important to note these awards are very important as they are concerned with the human rights. Now it's time for you to mention your answers in the comment section. So on which river is the Maitri Setu being built? So the High Commissioner of India to Bangladesh, Rewa Ganguly Das, he has inspected the ongoing construction which is there on this Maitri Setu bridge. Now there is another name of this Maitri Setu as well, and that is the river on which this Maitri Setu is being built. So for this it's important for you to know that this bridge is located in Tripura. So now what has happened is that Maitri Setu, that is built on the river which has the same name as it is being popularly known as. So you need to tell me in the comment section that where is this or which river is this Maitri Setu being built. You can guess the answer from the state Tripura. So I hope you know the answers. Do mention them in the comment section. And if you have learned anything from this video, do not forget to subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon as well to receive the notifications. We'll be soon coming up with the next video. I hope you have watched the NABARD analysis as well. Thank you so much for watching the video.